Hi friends, welcome back to Angular unit testing series. In this series, I'm talking about unit testing in Angular using Jasmine framework. In the last video, I have explained about how we can test a custom directive in Angular. In this video, I'm going to explain how we can test routing in Angular. Let's start. I'm taking the same example which I have used in my last video. I haven't changed the existing codes a lot because if I modify, it may break our previous test cases. But I have created a new component called info and added some routes in the routing module. The first route is an empty path route and we are redirecting that to home route. And we have another route to navigate to info component. And so we can see this. When I load the application without any route, it is redirecting to home route and we are seeing home component here. In home component, I have created a link to route it to info component. And so if I click this link, we can see the route is getting changed to info. And so we can see the info component. In info component, I have a button to navigate back to the home component. And so if I click this button, we can see we are going back to the home component. Okay, let's test these routes. The CLI has not created any spec file for routing module. Let's create that manually. In the spec file, let me create the describe block. Let me give a name. Let me create an asynchronous before each block. And a synchronous before each block. Inside the asynchronous block, let me configure the testing module. I need to import the router testing module, and using the with routes function, I can pass the routes. For that, I need to export the routes from here. Also, I need to declare the app component and the other components we are using in the app routing module. And let me import app component, home component, and info component. Also, as we are using grade pipe in app component, we need to import that as well. And let me call the compile components function as well. And inside the synchronous block, I need to create the instance of the router. For that, first let me create a variable called router of type router. And then here, let me inject that in the testbed to create an instance. And let me also call the initial navigation function in the router instance to start the initial navigation. Now let me create the test case. It should navigate to the default path home. I need to wrap this inside a wait for async because this navigation is going to be asynchronous. And first thing we need to do is to trigger the change detection. For that we need to have a fixture. Let me create a variable called fixture of type component fixture. And inside this block, let me create the fixture from testbed and assign it to the fixture variable. Now I can use fixture.detectChanges to trigger the change detection. After that, let me use fixture.whenStable. This whenStable function is used to resume testing after events have triggered asynchronous activity or asynchronous change detection. This is going to give us a promise. And so let me use a then method to resolve this promise. Inside this, I can expect the location path is going to be home. For that, I need to create a variable called location of type location. We need to import this location from angular/common, otherwise it will not work. And I can inject that also to the testbed. Now in expect, I can check whether the location.path is equal to home. We can see our test is passing. Let's test the other requirement. When we click this link, whether it is routing to the info route. For that, let me create a test case. It should navigate to info on clicking the link in home component. Also here, we need to access this DOM element from home component. For that, let me create a new fixture. and let me create that here. And inside here, let me use this new fixture dot detect changes. To access the DOM element, I need to create a debug element from this fixture. Let me create the same. And I can use the query all function to get all the anchor elements. Now I need to trigger the click event on the first anchor element. Like this. After that, when the fixture is stable, let me expect the location path to be info. Let me save. We can see our test is passing. Similarly, we can create another test case to test whether on clicking this button, it is routing back to home component. Let me quickly copy this. Let me create a new fixture for info component. And a new debug element from this fixture. And change this code accordingly. Here, I need to expect home. Let me save. We can see our test case is passing. This is how we can test the routing. Hope you understood. That's all for today. Please like this video and support me. I'll be back with the next concept soon. Thank you. Bye.